Okay. Now, Adam and I were just talking about this, and he was like, hey, you should do a video on this, but I don't need to anymore because I don't need to come up with the workaround. This month, we're announcing the ability to paste into the new list and button slicers. It's in preview. So what this means is that this month you can copy the values from tools like Excel or Notepad to your clipboard, then either select paste from the ellipsis button in the visual header or use Control V after selecting the slicer. Ensure each value it's in its own line. Hierarchy levels are separated by tabs and the order matches the columns in the field well. For instance, to filter for the second quarter of 2025, write 2025 quarter two with a tab between. Exclude headers. Be sure to exclude headers from your data.
Starting this month, you can now paste a series of values into the new list and button slicers that are in preview. All you need to do is copy the values you want to filter by to your clipboard from tools such as Excel or Notepad. Each individual value should be on its own line, and levels of the hierarchy should be separated by a tab. As an example, if you want to filter by the second quarter of the year 2014, you would have 2014 tab quarter 2. Also, the order of the value should be in the same order as the columns within the field well. And just also make sure that your data does not include any headers. Once the data is on your clipboard, you can either select the paste option from the triple dot button in the visual header, or you could select the slicer and then just use Control V and paste the values in. And then everything from your clipboard would be automatically selected in the slicer. Just a few additional details to note here. Columns that use group on keys are not currently supported. And then when reading numbers and dates, we support both the short format for whatever your current culture is, and also the current column format that is set in the Power BI report. And then lastly, empty values within a row are treated as blank. We hope this feature will be a nice quality of life improvement whenever you need to select many values in the slicer all at once.
Wow, what a great demo. If you have any questions, comments, or you'd like to see more demos, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Power BI YouTube channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, a big thumbs up. And as always, for Microsoft and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.